Yeah, you read that right. I was a pretty big prankster during the first couple of years in college. I got 'em good, as the kids say, where is referring to those at the receiving end of the prank. Not really, that's a lie. You know how the typical goal of the prank is to elicit some sort of reaction from the person being pranked? Well, mine didn't do that. At all. The pranks I did were stupid and extremely anticlimactic, so really the title and thumbnail of this video are just a big prank. So you just got pranked.
Got him!
My first scheme was at the start of freshman year and included the assistance of my roommate Dylan and another friend from our dorm hall named Jake. We were all pretty new to the area, so we would go on little adventures every weekend to explore the shops and places to eat downtown. One of the more interesting stores was called Rocket Fizz. It was known for its extremely large and bizarre selection of soda. It had normal flavors, but also really weird ones like apple pie, coffee, and bacon. Not all at once, those were three separate flavors, but you get the point. The selection was crazy. It also doubled as a candy shop. But none of that is relevant, because what caught my eye were these life-size cardboard cutouts that they had around the store. They were all characters from popular media like Sheldon from The Big Bang Theory, Dorothy from Wizard of Oz, and Elsa from Frozen. At first, I thought they were just some pop culture decoration, but then I noticed that they were for sale. For some reason, I believed that owning one of these figures would be extremely entertaining, so I pitched this completely ingenious idea. What if we bought this life-size Elsa cardboard cutout, brought it back to the dorm, and then one night we snuck it into the dorm common room, which was where everybody on the floor hung out. Then in the morning, there would be a random Elsa figure in the common room, and nobody would know how it got there. In theory, this was absolutely hilarious, so we decided to do it. After buying the cutout, we realized there was a slight problem. We had ridden our bikes to the store because none of us had cars. This meant that somebody would have to ride their bike back to the dorm in front of countless pedestrians and drivers holding a life-size Elsa cutout. It was decided that Jake had the least amount of shame, so he took the honors. Once we got back, we utilized advanced stealth procedures to transport the figure to our room without being seen. I got up at about 5:30 in the morning to sneak it into the common room. And this is about where the story ends, because nothing else interesting happens. Like I said before, these are very anticlimactic pranks. The people in my dorm hall kind of just accepted the presence of a large Elsa cardboard cutout and didn't question it any further. Someone ended up printing out a Pepe face and taping it to the head, but that was about all the attention it got. I even tried to stir up a response by moving it to a new location every night. From the common room to a study room, back to the common room, and to the end of the hall where it ended up staying for the rest of its life. If you looked to the second floor of the building from outside, you could see Elsa staring back at you through the window. Then, a month later, it suddenly vanished. I don't know if someone just decided to throw it away, but it was never seen again. The second prank I did that year involved these boards that the RA would set up in the middle of the dorm hall. For those of you that don't know, RA stands for Resident Assistant, and they are students that are usually 1 or 2 years ahead of everyone in the dorm hall, and they're sort of like the parents of the hall, enforcing dorm rules and planning dorm activities. So every month they would put up a new announcement board that sometimes involved campus activities that you could take part in, or were motivational with advice on how to establish good study habits or something. They were the sort of thing that you would expect to find in an elementary school classroom. One month, the board had a bunch of envelopes with little slips of paper in them. Each envelope correlated to each day of the month. The theme of this setup was doing one nice thing each day, meaning you were supposed to look at the slip of paper in each envelope and perform the task given to you. These nice tasks included things like give a compliment to one stranger or pay for a friend's lunch. At least, that's what I think they said. I didn't read them too thoroughly because I felt the need to replace them with my own acts of kindness. So, I typed out and printed my own slips of paper. About 30 of them total. I even made sure to type them in the same font as the originals and cut them to the same size in order to deter any suspicion. Late one night, I went out in the hall and replaced all the slips of paper in the envelopes with my own. Some examples of my own acts of kindness included, make sure to feed and water your roommate daily, Wearing a hat is a sign of compensation in men. If a baby cow is called a calf, you can also call your leg muscle a baby cow. And go out of your way to stroke a really pale person. Pretty much just whatever came to mind when I was making them. 30 of them. Unfortunately, this did not produce any sort of response in my fellow dorm mates, probably because no one actually looked at the board, but it did get some attention from the RA. Each month, there was a floor meeting where everyone in the hall would meet up and the RA would talk about rules and go over certain procedures. During the next meeting, my envelope slips got an honorary mention when she said that someone replaced the slips on the board and that disciplinary action would have to be taken on whoever was found to have done it. This, of course, was completely ridiculous because the things I wrote were harmless. Regardless, they never caught me, and yes, this is a confession. It was me the whole time. Do with me what you will.
I regret nothing.
My last prank was done sophomore year when I was still in the dorms. At this point, I had already taken to a life of crime and enjoyed tampering with the posters and signs that were hung up in the dorm halls. There was a pretty typical motivational university poster that said, "Our Road to Success," with some clip art of a road and the university logo right next to it. It was so boring and uninspired that I couldn't stand it. It obviously needed modification. I took the paper down and used some whiteout so that it simply read, "Our Road to Suck." Now, I wasn't just going to replace it. That would have been too easy and would have probably gone unnoticed. Instead, I took it to the library, scanned it, and made about 40 copies. I wanted to take this slow. My plan was to start by putting up just one poster in the hall. Then, every week after that, I would double the number of posters I put up from the week before. I wanted to see how many I could add before the RA noticed and took them down. I got past week 3 before they were noticed. That means that there were a mere 7 posters hanging before they were taken down. That was completely unsatisfactory, and I had 33 more posters to be used. So, a week later, I put up 10 posters. Then a week after that, I put up the final 23 all in one night. And they weren't all taken down each time because I tried to put them in places where they weren't completely obvious, like at the end of the hall, in a bathroom stall, and under the stairwell. The one under the stairwell lasted till the end of the semester. It's still there for all I know. As with the other pranks, this one didn't elicit a response either, except from the RA who would take them down without saying anything. Moral of the story is that it made me laugh, so it was totally worth it.
Hey there. Thanks for watching.
The reason I did this on a dry erase board is, one, I thought it'd be fun, and two, because my drawing tablet broke and is currently being repaired somewhere many miles away. So, Anyway, thanks, bye. Anyway, thanks, bye.